Hi kids! Today in Bible videos, we're gonna learn about the story of David and Jonathan. Are you ready to learn more about them? Let's get started! After God rejected Saul as king, the Spirit of God left him and he was sometimes tormented by an evil spirit. His servant suggested a young musician called David be bought in to play the harp to comfort the king. Whenever Saul was tormented, David would play his harp and the evil spirit would leave. And after David killed Goliath, he returned as a hero and King Saul became very angry and jealous of him. The next day, as David was playing the harp, Saul had a spear in his hand. He hurled it, saying, "I'll pin him to the wall," but David eluded him twice. But Saul planned to get David killed in battle, so he made him commander over 1,000 men. However, the Lord was with David, and he was victorious in battles, making him even more popular. Now Saul's daughter Michal was in love with David, and when they told Saul about it, he was very pleased. So Saul offered his daughter Michal in marriage to David if he killed 200 Philistines. David did not think himself worthy to become the king's son-in-law, but took up the challenge. David was not killed by the Philistines as Saul hoped, but returned in triumph and took Michal as his wife. And Saul became afraid of David as he knew the Lord was with him. King Saul had a son named Jonathan. He became a close friend of David and gave him his tunic, sword, bow, and his belt. They made a promise to remain friends. And Saul told Jonathan to kill David, but he kept his promise and instead of attacking David, he warned him that his life was in danger. And he then spoke well of David to Saul and made the king promise not to harm David. And after another victory against the Philistines, David was playing his harp for King Saul. The king became tormented and threw his spear at David, who dodged out of the way. The spear drove into the wall and David fled back home. So Saul sent men to David's house to keep it under watch. And then in the morning, he ordered his servants to kill him. But David's wife Michal warned him, saying, "If you don't run for your life tonight, tomorrow you'll be killed." And she led him down through a window to make his escape. Michal took an idol and laid it on the bed, covering it with a garment and putting some goat's hair at the head. The next morning, when the soldiers arrived, she pretended David was ill. When Saul told them to bring David to him, they discovered the figure in the bed was an idol. So David fled all the way to Ramah to see Samuel and tell him all that Saul had done to him. And then David arranged a secret meeting with Jonathan. They made a promise to show kindness to each other and their families. And the next day was the new moon feast, and David was supposed to dine with the king, but he was going to hide in a field instead. And Jonathan agreed to let David know if Saul was angry and was still planning to kill him. And they arranged a secret signal involving an arrow being shot to let David know whether it was safe or needed to flee. So David hid in the field. When the new moon feast came, the king sat down to eat. David's place was empty, and Saul did not comment why David was missing. But the next day, when David's place at the table was still empty, Saul asked, "Why isn't David here?" Jonathan gave the excuse that he and David had agreed and told his father that David was in Bethlehem with his family making a sacrifice. But Saul's anger flared at Jonathan and he shouted, saying, "You have sided with David to your own shame. As long as he lives, you will not become king. Send David to me so I can kill him." But Jonathan asked, saying, "Why should he be put to death? What has he done?" But Saul hurled a spear at Jonathan in anger, and there was no doubt that David's life was in danger. And the next morning, Jonathan went out to the field where David was hiding. And he called the small boy and said, "Run and find the arrows I shoot." And as the boy ran, he shot an arrow beyond him. And when the boy came to the place where Jonathan's arrow had fallen, Jonathan called out the secret signal he had made to warn David. And he said, "Isn't the arrow beyond you? Hurry, go quickly, don't stop." So the boy picked up the arrow and returned to his master. And Jonathan gave his weapons to the boy and said, "Go, carry them back to town." After the boy had gone, David got up from his hiding place and bowed down before Jonathan 3 times with his face to the ground. They kissed each other and wept together, but David wept the most. And Jonathan saw David and said, "Go in peace, for we have sworn friendship with each other in the name of the Lord. God is witness between you and me and between your descendants and my descendants forever." So the two friends departed, and David left to go into hiding, and Jonathan returned back home. The end. And I hope you had fun learning the story of David and Jonathan. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe for more Bible videos. Bye.